Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. So today we're going to be stabilizing our video clips, as you can see in the example here. So I'm using Blender version 2.8. If you want to use this as well, I'll make sure to throw a link in the description. So let's go ahead and change this to the VFX workstation. And I don't need these two windows, so I'm going to right click here and then join area. Do the same thing for this here, join area. And then go ahead and load up our movie clip. So this is the clip I'm using. If you want to use it as well, make sure you go to the link in the description and go ahead and download that. But the first thing we notice is the colors are not correct. So let's go over to the render panel, go down to color management, and then let's change this from filmic to standard. Now we can go ahead and set the scene frames, and this will set the timeline to be the length of your movie clip. So go ahead and click this button here. Then we can prefetch this. If this bar doesn't fill up all the way, you will need to go to edit, then to preferences, then over to system, and then just increase the memory cache limit. Then you can go ahead and click prefetch and it'll fill up all the way. So for this clip, we can see there's quite a bit of shaking and we want to get rid of that. And it's really, really simple. So let's jump back to the first frame. So now we're going to add some markers. Now for the location, you could just add one marker and it should be fine. But I like to add a couple of them just to give Blender a bit more information. So I'm going to add a couple of markers for the location and then I'm going to add two markers for the rotation. So let's go over to the tracking settings. For the motion model, I'm going to change this to location rotation. Then here, I'm going to change this to previous frame. And I'm also going to enable normalize. Then if we go over here to the track tab, when we add a tracking marker, we'll be able to see the preview over here. So let's go ahead and do that now. Let's add a tracking marker. I'm going to add one on this post here. And one more thing I want to do is activate the search size. So you could hold Alt S and just enable it that way. Or if you go over here to clip display, just enable search size, it's entirely up to you which way you do it. So I'm going to have one there. I'm going to have another one maybe over here. Scale this up a bit. And then maybe have one over here. And as I say, for this example, you probably only need one for the location and then two for the rotation. So it's up to you how many you add. So again, these are going to be for my location. Then we'll need two tracking points for the rotation. So I'm going to go over here. Click this and then have one over here, probably this tree here. Okay, so now I have these, I'm going to press A, select all of them. Then if I go down here, I'm going to track these forward. So now we have these, we need to define what the tracks actually do. So let's go over here to the stabilization tab and then up here at the top, let's just enable it. There we go. So I'm just going to press T and get rid of this sidebar here. So we've got quite a few things that we need to do. First, we need to add some tracks for the location. So as I mentioned, these three here are going to be the location. So if I press A just to deselect all of these, then I'm going to press B and then left click and just select all of these like so. Then if I go over here and press this plus button, these are now my location. We also want to enable auto scale, which will then do most of the work for us. Now we need to do the rotation. So up here we click this. And it's now added a new rotation section. So again, deselect these. Then I'm going to select both of these up here, these two rotation ones, and just add them here. Then if we play through, we'll see nothing's changed, and that's because we need to update the viewport, I guess. So jump back to the first frame. Then back at the top, if we go to clip display, we just want to go to here where it says show stable. So click this, and now we can see the stabilization. And if we play through, we can see that it's very stable. It's not moving at all. It's pretty good. If you don't want this to have automatic scale, you can turn this off. And then if you want, you can increase this yourself. So it's entirely up to you. But automatic scale does a very good job of keeping it to a minimum. So whilst also giving you a nice, clean, stable track. So now we have this and we're happy with it. Let's go over to the compositing tab. Then click use nodes. Then I want to select this render layers here, and we can either press X to delete, or if you have the node wrangler add-on enabled, you can hold shift and press S and just switch the type. So I'm going to switch this to a movie clip, then select this movie clip icon and choose the movie clip that we've been working with. Then if we hold Control Shift and then left click on this node, we'll be able to see a preview in the background. Now all we need to do is just add one node, so Shift A, go down to Distort, and then Stabilize 2D. Just drop this on here, connect this up to the viewer node as well. Then we can select this movie clip icon, choose the movie clip, and there we go. Now we have a nice stable movie clip. We have no shaking or jumping, and it looks a lot better. So you could add your color grading, add whatever else you need to, but now you want to render this out. Let's go to the output tab. And then we want to make sure that the video resolution is the same as the movie clip that we're using. We also want to make sure that this is at 100% as well. Then go down to output and set where you want to save this to. And then down a bit more, we can go to the file format and change this from a PNG to an ffmpeg video. Then over here to render, we can either click the render animation button or we can use the shortcut, which is Control F12. It's entirely up to you. But go ahead and render this out. So hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a like. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.